Rising Sun. How is everybody tonight? I'm so happy to be here. You guys enjoying your summer so far? I am so much looking forward to fall. It's my favorite time of year. Yeah, leggings and boots come back. It becomes popular. I can stop shaving again. Like, I go from no shave November, like, all the way to May. That's how I roll. But leggings and boots are a thing, so I always have to make sure I maintain in this area, you know, because otherwise that shit will pop right through your LuLaRoe's. And if you're anywhere where there's sunlight, people can see it. It looks like you have a hedgehog in your pants. I thought of getting a wax done, like a bikini wax, like a Brazilian, but I'm a super gassy girl. And I just thought, she's gonna rip that wax. I'm gonna rip a fart. And I just don't know how much to tip in that situation. You'd be so lost. Yeah, so maintenance is important. The other thing I did realize once upon a time was that not only do you have to maintain here, but you have to maintain under here, which I didn't realize, but what happens is you get what I call a vulva mullet. So it's business in the front, party in the back. And the way I discovered this was I went to pull out a tampon, and I realized that the string had gotten braided, see how people have happened, had braided itself. And I gave myself a free Brazilian, and I farted. Another time it's important to make sure this part here is well maintained is where you go into the OBGYN office. I am always worried that she's gonna look and be like, oh, a mom haircut, how cute. Or this, you could be like, oh, well, she hasn't watched porn in a while. Or she could be like, oh, look, retro. But the worst part of going to the OBGYN is not actually the shaving, it is the amount of lubricant that the OBGYN uses. Right, and you go to hop off the table, she hands you a tissue and you're like, bitch, please. And you take that gown and you're just like. I feel quite certain that's where flossing came from. So I recently had a pregnancy scare, which is really bad when you're 50. It doesn't happen a lot, but you get to find out who you are as a human when you have a pregnancy scare. Okay, so my husband and I, we do still use condoms. We've been married 22 years, and it started after the birth of my last child. Sorry, that flossing takes a bit out of you. And I decided that this was the National Park Service. Carry in, carry out. No child left behind. And yes, I mix my government metaphors. It's my comedy, I can do what I want. But nonetheless, this thing happened and I really thought that I was a born again, Christian, Republican, pro-life woman. And then the condom broke. And what I said was, get me a plan B right now! So clearly I'm going to hell. But I don't think you have to shave there. So it's a win.